Welcome back, guys. It's Justin here with Slayfest Fishing. Hey, we got something special in store for you today. As you can see, I'm not on my boat. I had some issues with the lift. We couldn't get the lift to go down, something with the electrical. But hey, our neighbor was gracious enough to let us take his boat out for the day. So we're going to see if we can get some sheepshead action. We don't really know. It's just whatever we can get into. You know, it's wintertime, it's cold. It could be a tough bite, but we'll see what we can make happen. Hey, today on the boat, we got a special guest, Joseph Dent, professional golfer out of Augusta, Georgia.
What's up, guys? Well, I'm from Tampa originally, but, you know, it's an honor to be out here with you guys, Slayfest Fishing, and, you know, being able to catch some fish. And I haven't been on a boat in 2 or 3 years.
Hey, he getting my golf game right. I know that much. But, hey, we got Logan behind the camera, of course. We'll catch you out there.
I should have brought my clubs, man. I could hit a golf ball right here.
Need a 60 degree to get it over the bow.
All right, guys. Well, evidently that water temperature, I don't even have a machine to read the water temperature, but evidently it's too cold because bait's not on the flats, so we're gonna go with this dozen shrimp, dozen fiddler crabs. We're gonna go with what we got, see if we can catch some sheepshead or trout or something. We'll catch you when we get something on the line.
Oh shit, dude.
Damn, Joe?
Oh!
Oh, he got me. Damn, he came off.
He was really there, though.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's a good sign. First cast in. See if we can get on another.
Oh.
And when that line starts going, he's on there. You just see that line? Just leave it on the top.
I reel him in?
You want him to take it.
He's poking it.
That could be a sheepshead.
All right, guys, we're over here. We're trying to, what is it, snapper, snook?
That was a snapper, but we had a snook on earlier. You had a snook on earlier.
All right. Legends have said, biggest snook in the Gulf of Mexico. Over here, St. Pete.
Oh, baby one. Wow, they're here. That was pretty class. On the fiddler crab that time. He needs to be about four times that size so he can go home and get on my grill tonight.
So baby little fish.
Joseph, what happened?
Man, I put my bait in there and it's gone. I turned my head and when I looked back, it was gone.
I'm gonna tell you something about these fish before you start. Sheepshead, it ain't like a trout, it ain't like a snook. Those jokers, they follow it down to the bottom and they gonna be on it. And they know that hook's there. You got about 3, 4, 5 seconds to hook them. You gotta hook them a little harder than you do one of these fish because their mouth are all like, it's like our mouth, teeth.
Ah.
Yeah, so look, you gotta be just right on there. So
bad.
Put this over there, I'm gonna get you rigged up with a crab.
But they got dental fans and everything.
Only getting a little better, bit by bit.
Oh man.
So we got a crab on like a yellowtail jig.
16th ounce.
Going out. Go a little deeper this time. I didn't like that cast, but we're gonna try it. Let's see. Oh, he's got it, he's got it, he's got it.
Get him.
Missed him. All right, so we're out here. Looks like the sheep's head bite can save us today. Oh. They're trying me. There he goes, he's on her. Got a little one again, some sort. Man, a bunch of babies in there today. So that's number three, but they're all small, unfortunately. So we're gonna have to change something up. Maybe they want in deeper water. We gotta figure them out. First keeper, I think.
Nah, he's still small. Maybe not.
Yeah, you can call him.
Man,
he's size. He may be a keeper.
Whoa! This doesn't happen in golf, man.
Go. Real. You want one, Joe?
Let's go, Joe.
Nice and easy, Joe. Could be a keeper,
Joe. Break his ass in, Joe. Oh! Bring him up over.
Kahuna, Huna.
Let some line out.
How was that, Joe?
Shit, let some line.
Sensational.
Not a bad fish for Joseph. Go with him. Go with him.
Oh, yeah.
I think I got me a keeper on here. That or he's just pulling extra hard. Oh, nice snapper. He's going home. Nice mango. All right, 12-incher. Good snapper. I think we're going to put him in the live well. If we get another one, we're kicking him home.
Hey, it's like you get both of the fish in there and they're like, Hey, he got you too. There you go. There you go. He on there? He on there? What you got? Little snapper.
Hey,
oh, it's a grunt.
Right, let me see that. You got my snook bait for later.
Oh, that's the best snook bait there is, actually.
You got my bait for later.
I'm going to drop him down at the corner and get slammed by a snook. Take one for the team, buddy.
Not this time, buddy.
Waiting for him to drag it off now. And you just pull back slightly when he drags it. Ooh, Joe.
Huge, bro.
Ooh, Joe. What you got, Joe?
It's a banner. Keep the line up.
Oh, another snapper. Bring him in here.
All right, all right.
Got him again.
Little baby though.
Ooh, I'm a pro, bro.
Hold on, Joe. Hold on, Joe. I got one.
Dude, we really got two at like the same time.
Yeah, they small though. Some snappers. We get back on the sheep set action. Ooh, got my bait there.
You big, bro. Get him in here.
Nah, I don't know if that's a keeper, actually.
That's 10.
You guys want to keep him, really?
Yeah.
That's a little baby meat. It's good for frying, though.
Shit, I'm hungry, bro.
What you got to do is keep an eye on that line. Oh, now he's got it. See how he's got that?
It's going to be a big one, baby.
That's a baby. Sheephead, though.
All right, so fortunately a lot of small sheephead, but... Hey, you know, I mean,
talk to the camera, say hi.
It is what it is, you know what I mean?
Oh, man.
We wanted to get some keepers. We got a few snapper in there, but we're still on the hunt for some more food.
Hey.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Yeah, I got him.
Rod up.
Man, you ain't getting away this time, bro.
Oh, little baby. Just a big snapper. Baby mango. Snapper.
You take it home early.
Yeah, he's good.
Yes. Another keeper snapper. Hey, we just want some fish tacos today.
For real, bro.
Yeah. Another one for the box.
Oh, baby.
Embarrassment.
All right, guys. We're doing a little wrap-up video here. As you saw, we got some snappers, some sheephead, a bunch of them, actually. They're biting quick. It's just... smaller size fish, but hey, we still got four in the box, so we got Joseph on some fish over here.
Yeah,
too.
He's gonna teach me how to skin them and fillet them.
Hey, you have a good time out here,
man. I can't complain, man. This is awesome.
Yes,
I enjoyed
sir.
You guys, and thanks for having me. I hope to be back soon. You know, I hope you guys can still tune in and keep it going.
Yes, sir. Hey, as always, shout out to Mike, my neighbor. Wonderful neighbors, man. Hey, he let us use the boat. Hey, if you want a house in that neighborhood, remember I'm a realtor with EXP Realty. Give me a call. If you need a house anywhere, any real estate needs you may have.
All right, guys. So, as you know today, most of the fish were small, but we still came up with some fish for some... We're going to do some beer batter snapper. So, we got four snapper here to fillet. We do a little catch and cook with you guys. Show you guys how to fillet them up. All right, so we got our beautiful snapper here and a dull knife, but okay. We're going to start right there. Pick this pectoral fin up. Right down there like that. Ooh, that's nice dull. And then once you get it down like this, you know, nice clean cut, I turn the knife in there and I come right down this, down the backbone. You'll kind of feel it, like it won't let you go down too far. And you're just going to go right by this fin right here, all the way down on a snapper. Most fish is the same. Boy, this knife's dull. Just like that. And then when I get down here, I go above the spine and go all the way through. The back one, you can feel it's down there. Come all the way back. I lift it like this. This is what I do to get every bit of meat. And I just score this like this. Like this. And what you're doing is you're working the meat off of these bones that you can hear right here. So you're just going to keep working that down until you get to the center bone. When you get to the center bone, you get a new, lift it up again, come back down, and now you're going to cut more downward and get over the rest of those pin bones that run through the fish. You know, cut through every now and then.
like this. Peel it back. Maybe get a cleaner cut here. There we go, look. Now, when I fillet fish, I don't go through the rib cage. I don't even want them in the rib cage. So I actually go above. See, this is the rib cage, and this is just the regular bones that go down the fish. I go right over. And eventually, because there's no more meat down there, you can just cut right through. It's going to leave you something like that. You're going to do the same thing on this side, but for now, I'm going to show you guys something. You're going to take this piece over here, and I grab it with your fingernails a little bit, kind of come down like that, right? Now I'm going to skin my fish. I don't really scale them. I'm frying fish. I want no bones in them. I want no skin in them. So we're going to come down here like this. You want a flat surface, and you want your knife flat, and you almost want to just pull the fillet towards you while you push the knife forward slowly. And what that's going to do is like that. Just skin. That's all that's left. Now you're going to take what you got left. You got a nice piece of meat for frying. You know, just flip it over like this. And you're going to see this little bloodline run down here. And when you get to right here, for some reason right here, there's some bones left. So you go like this. Trim that. And trim that. Cut like this. And that's bones. And basically, and it depends how far you want to take it. If you want to clean it up a little bit, you clean it up. Some people want to cut this off a little bit like that. Boom, clean it up. This is cartilage right here, actually. You can get some of this off with your knife here. It's going to come off anyways when you cook it. But some people get it off now so it doesn't stay in the pan or wherever you're frying or whatever. And basically, you have a nice snapper fillet right there. You repeat the same process on the other side. So we'll catch you in the kitchen. All right, guys, now we're in the kitchen. We got the fish over there. We're gonna do about a cup of flour, put some garlic powder in that, maybe like a tablespoon. Some paprika, maybe like a tablespoon. Do like a teaspoon of pepper. I do probably a teaspoon and a half of salt, something like that. Put that in there. Get a little whisk around while it's dry. Get that mixed up. All right, now you're gonna take one egg and beat it up a little bit first. Put that in there. Take a beer, put some of that in there. We're making beer battered fried fish. You're gonna stir it like this. What you want is like more of a, not like cookie dough, you want like a liquidy. So you can put some beer in there. Let's get it to go. We got two more things I'm going to recommend: onion powder and chili powder. Maybe a little dash of the chili powder, maybe a little dash of the onion powder, something like that. I like onion powder a little more. Mix that in. And when you do beer powder, you want it to be like that. Honestly, maybe even a little more. You want it to be nice and runny. That'll do it. Alright, so what you're going to need for this is you want to bring your oil to about 375. Need a little thermometer you just stick in there. Meat thermometer, doesn't matter. I'd say 2-3 inches of oil. Whatever oil you like to fry with, whatever you got. Alright, a few tips for you. So we're at our temperature, so I'm going to start backing off the heat actually. 380. Want to be about 375. A few tips for you. You want the fish to be extremely dry. Pat it down good. I don't know why that is. You just want it to be dry. Whenever you're cooking any meat, you want it to be dry. Second tip, I like to cut it up in little bits and make nuggets out of it. It depends what you're doing. You making tacos, do full pieces. You do you, whatever you want. But tonight we're doing little nuggets, a little appetizer to some chili my mom made. All right, so you take your pieces like that, drip them off, lay them away from you, and you got to just get going. Look at that, boom. Just get going with them, get going with them. Bingo, bingo. I'm going to try to get all of them at once. All right, so we got them cooking up. They're almost done. I'm going to say another 10, 20 seconds on these guys. We'll probably finish them. All right, guys, we are finished up. Beer battered snapper. Hey, it was a great day of fishing. Hey, swimming around 4 hours ago, fresh as it gets.
Yep, fresh off the reef or ocean.
Yeah, the reef, that's good. Let's dig in.
Yeah, man, I'm ready. It's all good.
By far.
Yeah, I know.